Welcome back. You're watching The Wallet. Now, the oil and gas sector is one that has attracted a lot of interest, more so on how the people, let's say, in the Telenga region, where the project is happening now, can be dealt with. We talk about the people, the animals, and the oil itself. In this report, we speak to an expert from Total E&P who will tell you what they are currently doing to ensure that the three can coexist. The good news also, the gentleman recently won an award that has put him above almost every other young person in the oil and gas sector. The general discussion on how to conserve the environment, ensure the well-being of the people, and exploration of oil is some discussion that has for a while attracted attention from the different spectrum of people. But one David Ochanda, the biodiversity coordinator at Total E&P Uganda, knows just well how this can be done, which is the reason he recently won the International Association of Oil and Gas Producers Outstanding Young Professional Award 2020. David has successfully led the development of the biodiversity program for Total E&P Uganda, specifically designing the net gains activities that will guide the development of the Telenga project in an environmentally responsible manner. In this week's oil industry update, we catch up with David, who shares with us vast information on how to ensure the development of the Telenga project with minimal impact on biodiversity and ecosystem services.
The awards is the IOGP, International Association of Oil and Gas Producers, Outstanding Young Professionals Award, that is done every 2 years. So an individual is nominated by high caliber individuals within the companies, all the different oil and gas companies. They nominate different individuals that they think are worthy of that award. So luckily enough, I was one of those that were chosen by Total to be nominated for this award. And what happens is you do submit a video. Once you're nominated, you submit a video that describes the activities that you do. I did submit that, and I was, you know, privileged and lucky enough to be the winner. So the competition is really to encourage the young generation within the industry, that's the oil and gas industry, recognize those who are really quite remarkable in the industry, so that it develops them for the future as future leaders. So what happened is, being a new industry, we've set up here a lot of activities, okay, that these activities are more or less pioneering what is being done by Total E&P for the industry in terms of environmental conservation. We set up cameras, okay? We set up cameras into this plane so that as you survey the park, then you're able to still capture the information that the humans into the plane would have done. So that's one way of being innovative as one of the areas of dealing with a new industry in the country. One is being innovative, okay, and being creative in whatever activities you undertake. And then secondly is about capacity building and awareness. So we do a lot of capacity building for our stakeholders. But what we are doing as Total E&P Uganda is a commitment to international best practices. Now, these international best practices put in place measures that companies or development partners need to follow, so as to, you know, try and mitigate the impact that the development would have on the, you know, the wildlife, the conservation itself, the people that you've mentioned, as well as the tourism. So what we've done is we've designed several mitigation measures that have really helped us in foreseeing the potential impacts that could could be existent onto these features, and then mitigate those appropriately. Yes, I can say the government is doing quite good work in terms of supporting Total. A lot of the activities that we are designing under what we call the net gain program. The net gain program here literally a meaning that after our years of operation and developing the Tilenga project, we should leave the landscape we are working in an improved or better state than we found it. I think I must say that first of all, I'm extremely delighted to have received this award. It means a lot to me individually, but also it's really a demonstration of, you know, the empowerment that I've been having in the country in Total, the affiliate here. I've been, you know, having a lot of empowerment to undertake my work, the trust and confidence that my seniors and colleagues have, you know, put in me. That is really a very good demonstration of having received this award.
Interesting stuff there coming from the oil and gas sector. Let's cross to what we would call a regional wrap, but today we'll talk about ICT and how it is supporting businesses. Now, Amazon is increasing its coverage during the lockdown and after the lockdown. Now, this is aimed at ensuring that more people can access services just at their doorsteps without necessarily moving out. Of course, since COVID stepped in, there has been a debate whether ICT should stand out to support people, or the big question for Uganda has been, can Ugandans adapt the usage of ICT to cut off the costs of operating? But in this report, let's see what Amazon is doing to ease the lockdown, but also extend services to the people. Amazon is ramping up its online grocery service with the aim of serving millions of shoppers across the UK by the end of 2020. Online food sales have almost doubled during the pandemic, with groceries struggling to keep up with demand. Amazon is now after a bigger slice of this fast-growing market, which analysts say could increase pressure on rivals. Shoppers have to subscribe to Amazon Prime to get it, and users currently have to pay an additional monthly fee or a delivery charge per order. It has about 10,000 products, including fresh, chilled, and frozen food. From last week, the service has been a free benefit to subscribers in these areas on orders above $40. About 40 postcodes in survey will also have access to a faster offer with a possible same-day delivery before midnight if you order by 9 o'clock. Amazon says it will roll out the quicker and unlimited free delivery grocery service to multiple cities by the end of this year. It's also far more difficult for grocers to make a profit with online sales compared to customers visiting stores. Amazon's target is going to be fairly premium, as it has signed a lot of deals with smaller independent suppliers. All of the established players have been rapidly building online capacity to cope with soaring demand, which many believe will be a permanent shift in shopping behavior. Amazon's expansion means this part of the $119 billion grocery market is going to become even more competitive in the coming months. Now, you can be a part of the show by following us on our social media handles, that is Urban Television on Facebook, Urban TV Uganda on Twitter. Tell us what you think about the show. Better still, you could hit me directly on my social media handles right below your screen. I'll be more than glad to respond to your concerns. Time now for personal finance tips for this week. Let's run you through them. And this week we are talking about shopping smart tips. This week on personal finance, we discuss how to shop smart. These are five critical points that you have to consider before you go shopping. 1. Evaluate purchases by cost per use. It may seem more financially reasonable to buy a trendy $5 shirt than a basic $30 shirt, but only if you ignore the quality factor. When deciding if the latest tech toy, kitchen gadget, or apparel item is worth it, factor in how many times you will use it or wear it. For that matter, you can even consider cost per hour for experiences. 2. Spend money on experiences, not things. Putting your money towards purchases like a concert or a picnic in the park instead of spending in a price-free material object gives you more happiness for your buck. 3. Shop solo. Ever have a friend declare, "That's so cute on you, you have to get it," for everything you try on? Save your socializing for a walk in the park instead of a stroll through the mall, and treat shopping with serious attention. 4. Spend on the real you, not the imaginary you. It's easy to fall into the trap of buying for the person you want to be, chef or a professional stylist. And finally, ditch the overdraft protection. Of course, it sounds nice, but it's actually a way for banks to tempt you to overspend and then charge a fee for the privilege. Find out more about overdraft protection and other banking mistakes to avoid. Personal finance tips for this week, purposely on how to shop smart.
Well, amazing stuff there for you. The one that stands out for me is solo shopping. Now, have you ever gone shopping and almost everything that you touch, your friend will tell you either it suits you or you look smart on it? It's important for you to go shopping alone because you'll be able to think about how much you want to spend rather than going shopping in a group because it's risky. My name is Simon Oktela. This has been The Wallet. Remember, the show airs every Mondays at 10:30 p.m. here on Urban TV, but the repeat is on Saturdays at 8 p.m. So you can be sure to catch the main show plus the repeat. Remember, as a business person, every time you get out to try, put something and make some profits, some key things are basic, but you have to ensure that you follow them. For instance, when you borrow money, what do you use for? 2, do you budget before you do everything? Let's say restocking of your business, or are you the kind of person that just keeps borrowing money and putting in your business even when you're not making profits? Also, the other thing that is interesting around this lockdown time or the COVID-19 time is that most companies have been struggling with whether they should fire employees or not. I'll tell you one thing for sure. Training employees that you already have could be more costly than you thinking that you could hire new ones and start off again. Until then, we'll see you soon. Thank you so much for watching. Bye for now.